What's up, guys? Welcome to today's video, guys. And today we're going to be playing a full online ranked match here. Just kind of walk you through the offense, and hopefully you guys can pick up on some things that I do well. And we're showing you this offense without audibles. And you know, I think there's something to be said about running a playbook without audibles, especially with the movement that is Madden Ultimate Team and the way that it's getting popular. And this is a scheme that you can run in Madden Ultimate Team and be pretty effective. Now, here I'm going to motion out that hitch route and get started off with a quick little man beater to Wes Welker out there on that sideline. And that's really the way we're going to start a lot of games, guys. You're going to see a lot of that today. You're going to see a lot of that route. You're going to see a lot of PA post. A lot of the bunch, because I think that it does a really good job at beating especially a lot of popular defenses like two man under, like cover two sink, all those defenses. It does a really good job at beating. Here you see again, I'm going to try to get it going again, and there you see Wes Welker. I was just going to quickly work that hitch route for a while. They're accidentally hit the game flow button. I wish they'd take that out of the game, but it is what it is. And sometimes when you get in the flow, you hit something you don't want to. But you call a timeout. you waste timeout, you burn a calorie, and you live with it. All right, here in this situation, I mean, you see how he's kind of shaking the linebackers around. That's a quick tell that he's probably blitzing. So I'm going to go to the ATL deep end. I'm not going to go to the actual blitz beater just yet. And the reason for that is because I don't quite necessarily know for sure that he's blitzing. There you see that little route to Noshon Marino out of the ATL deep end. Play is really effective, guys, especially with that motion slant route. I thought we were supposed to motion just the in route, but I'm telling you right now, I've been motioning that slant route ever since. Haven't looked back. Think it was one of the better adjustments that you can make to that play. Here you see the backed off coverage. That initiates a blitz because he just pressed out of that. In a second and six situation, we'll just see what he's all about. As far as the blitz goes, remember we like to set up a drag and a slant on the right side of the field as well to just quickly initiate that. There we see it was a man coverage. We were able to get the ball to Noshon Marino, get it out of our hands quick, pick up a couple yards. I think that was actually a man-to-man pressure blitz. And so now we know what he's about with that psycho formation. We could probably do a really decent job at beating that with the ATL deep end. Here in this situation, you see the backed off coverage. Probably going to press him. He does end up pressing. I'm going to motion out Wes Welker and try to get a man beater going on there. I just bad users. I mean, the route was wide open. Unfortunately, I just didn't make a good user play. Here in this situation, beginning of the game, I don't want to give up possession to my opponent. I think possessions are really valuable, a lot more valuable than people really think. And in situations like this, fourth and two, where I think that I can, you know, kneel down for 2 yards against this guy, I really want to try and take advantage of this opportunity. Here, I feel like he's been giving me this look like 5 or 6 times, and every time it's been just two man under. There, I couldn't throw the ball. I don't know what happened. That's on me. Sometimes with that hitch route, sometimes you try to throw it a little too quick. That's what happened there, and end up not doing too well. So now we're on defense. But, I mean, you'll see how this really doesn't affect me that much, in my opinion, simply because of the fact that, you know, most of the time with our first drive, we're going to score anyway. So now what I'm just trying to do is find my base play, and I can't get to it. So I'm going to just hop into the cover three and rock it for a little bit. Here again, guys, I really like to user control Mike Huff. I think that gives me the best chance to stop a lot of what people do. There he's going with the PAFL slide out of the shotgun split. Here he's going no huddle, going to pick up the pace. So we're going to have to, here we go, we're going to drop the hook. We've got to get down here for the option. Probably going to be an option here. Load option. And he gets outside. Nate Irving does not tackle. Raheem Moore does not tackle, and he's going to score a touchdown. That's fine. So, starting off a little bit, a little rusty here. Wouldn't appreciate, don't really appreciate the tackling there. Felt like, you know, obviously it was a good call. It could have been about 10 yards, but because we weren't in the run defense, and it's all right, but it is what it is. Come to think of it, I don't even can't remember. We call the cover three, and then I think we just blitz that linebacker, don't we? Hope that's right. Hope I follow the setup instructions so I don't mess this up for you guys, because I do want to stay consistent with what I talked about in my videos. Back to the bunch, and here I'm a little frustrated after last drive, so what you're going to see right here is I'm pretty much going to destroy him right now with this hitch route, because I'm a little frustrated about what happened last drive. And that's what happens when you get frustrated. Dang it, that's so stupid. That's twice in a row where it's been wide open, and I just couldn't catch it. Son of a buck. Alright, so bad play by me. And finally got in the base play. I figure we go no huddle every play. Got the hook zone. Get over there with Huff. Load option again. Russell Wilson now. And you can't stop that. That's retarded. Gosh dang it. So basically what we've seen is that I can't stop the run, and also that I can't catch football. So basically all we've seen, and I can't throw a football. So all that we don't know yet is, can I stop the pass, and can I run the ball? That's all we know. That's all we haven't figured out yet. Oh, great. Start out 14-0. So we're going to have to fight on this game of the week. And there's a kick return tip once again getting to the edge. Unfortunately, we weren't able to seal the deal. I feel like I should get a kick return in this game with Trenton Holiday. It's good to see his. I mean, if my defense keeps letting up touchdowns like that, I probably have a lot of opportunities to do that. All right, so I'm a little bit upset about the man coverage every play, so we're going to go to the ATL deep end and say screw you. But, you know, I mean, he just teleports through Wes Welker's body. I mean, that is what it is. See, and that's what frustrates me. People who complain about, like, you know, are you playing Sim? Are you not playing Sim? Things like that. Those are the same people that literally call two men under every single play. No defense is going to call one play an entire game. Fact, not opinion. That's a fact. And I don't understand how we get the flack because we're not Sim, while the Sim guys don't even call the regular, like, a legitimate game plan. They just call the same plays over and over again. And you'll find that the best of both worlds actually can play against each other and be okay. What you get, though, is you get the two or three people that, and there's an out route, you're welcome. The reason I threw it, I was just mad. You know, I'm just upset. I'm a little upset about the way that we can just, you know, call man bump and be fine. You know, I'm a little upset about that. I'm a little saucy. Because I can't catch the ball. Why can't I catch the ball? I'm serious, guys. I've literally ran this play like a million times. And I was like, I run it in MUT all the time, and I catch the ball fine in MUT. And I catch the ball fine in a regular game. I don't know what's going on right now. I just literally can't catch it. Calls this bump out of that literally every time. I mean, just clockwork. And it's going to be two men under. Every single time. Every single time it's two men under. Every play. Literally every play. And he's about to get a lesson in two men under, because I'm getting sick and tired of this. So if you see what he's doing, you see how he's bumping. You see that's what throwing me off. Okay, so watch this. We're gonna go to the ATL, and this is a little adjustment for all you fans at home. Demaryius Thomas on a streak. Block Moreno, block Thomas. We're gonna bring Welker in, we're gonna put him on an in route, and we're gonna go. You see how he beat the bump? You see how Demaryius Thomas beat the bump and he has no safety over top? That's a little lesson right there. If you're going to run bump blitz like that all freaking game, you're going to get dotted. You're going to get dotted. So, yes, is the bump blitz good? Yeah, is the bump blitz... I mean, you saw. I mean, it shut me down for the majority part of the beginning of the game. But you can't run it all game. And that's a fact. Because if you run bump blitz all game, I will dot you. And not only will I dot you, I will dot you repeatedly again and again and again, because that's all he wants to do. Run bump blitz. I got unbumpable routes for that. Okay, that's why you have PA posts in your playbook. So you guys know, obviously I got a little saucy about that. I'm a little saucy about the man blitz thing. But real quick here, we're going to run the, unfortunately, Devin, ah, dang it. So Demaryius Thomas is tired. That's great. So we're going to have to put Decker over there. Decker has good catching traffic, though. I mean, he's good. Okay, so we got Caldwell there for now. Okay, so you will see what we're going to do. We're going to come out in the close cross, and we're going to audible to Bill's fade. And then we're going to audible back by resetting the play. Then we're going to put Decker on a fade. And I'm going to have to call a timeout anyway. Gosh dang it, I'm so pissed. What? Stupid accelerated clock runoff or whatever they do to this game. Well, at least now we can get Thomas back in the game. I'm glad for that. Here I like to put Decker over there in Welker's position, because especially on the goal line, because Decker has better catch and traffic, and I don't need the deep threat of Decker like I do on the bunch to actually make it even matter if he's on the field. So you'll see right here. And there it is. There's a play right there. We're going to motion Decker across. You see he doesn't pay attention to Thomas, and we're just going to throw that fade up. Unfortunately, Thomas drops the ball, but you live and die by the fade. You live and die by that. You know, I'm going to live and die by my guy. You know, I'm not going to go away from something just because he drops the ball a couple times. You know, I mean, as you saw, I mean, I'm not going to go away from the bunch route just because I scored a touchdown on that, I believe. So I'm not going to go away from the bunch. I'm not going to change my game plan. And that's, stay consistent, guys. I mean, if you're consistent over the long haul, typically, you know, things may not work once, but they'll systematically, I mean, they'll eventually come together. I mean, obviously, you don't want to keep calling the same play. You saw I adjusted out of that and okay, so we got to stop this load option crap. There we are. So, see, you don't run the same play every time. I'm talking schematics. I'm not talking play. Okay, so let's get that straight. I'm not talking play. See, now it's going slip screen. Now I got a guy in the seam. Whatever. You know, whatever. Whatever you want to do, bro. But the idea is you come out and you stick to your game plan. Here I'm going to send some pressure off that. I'm going to try to send some pressure. I'm going to try to send some pressure. And I got to get off that guy. He wants to go to this route. Every time. I'm sitting right there. I literally hate Madden 25's user control. Literally hate it. Because I was sitting on the route. I told you where he was throwing the ball. And I still couldn't stop it. Got a flat and a purple zone over there. And they still don't stop it. That's frustrating. But, you have to deal with that. Here you're going to see it's going to be more. Now we're going to go strong power because the option wasn't more. Yep, still option. Okay. I got guys over there. I ain't worried about that. No huddle. Ew, sucks so bad. Gosh! Ran a freaking draw. Ah! So right there, I called blitz. Called the right edge blitz, right B gap. And whatever. I mean, it is what it is. But obviously, I can get frustrated about it, but it ends there. Okay? It doesn't continue to the next play. That kind of mentality is what you have to have in this game. Here we're going to run a load option or the slip screen. I got the flat. Here I'm about done with this stupid slip screen. And I blow it in the backfield and Marshawn Lynch just trucks. It is what it is. Okay, so real quick here, let's cycle through one thing you can do to shut this down. So you're seeing a lot of the same thing over and over and over and over again, spamming on no huddle every time. What I have to do here, this is something that I'm not good at doing, is running coverage D. That's the answer right here, right now. Because I have to slow him down. So like right here, this is perfect situation. So you run the coverage D. You say, okay, I'll just run the coverage D. Take the safety away on this side of the field. Man a line. Watch the corner route. And we got a guy underneath. We got a guy over there. It is what it is. Okay, the game sucks. It is what it is. We think the game sucks. Well, it does. But it doesn't. Every game's going to suck if you want to look at it like that. Okay, so the way I see it, you have to adjust. You just have to adjust. Okay? That's all it is. You have to be in the game. You have to have a defense that will keep you in the game so that you can make that adjustment. And an offense as well. So that when you get down 14-0, you're not going to be down 21-0 because your offense sucks or your defense sucks. See, it's got to be systematic. It's got to be consistent. What a lot of people do is they just get mad, and then that's it. Okay, there's no change, there's no nothing. What is this, flip trips? Yeah, all he's got is a draw. So right there, this is flip trips. So he can't run like buck sweep out of this. He can't run like base. So there's no running threat. So I could drop into a pressure blitz off the edge or something like that off the left side, because there's no running threat of him actually being a problem. Okay, here I need to watch out for that corner route, but I got a purple over there, so we should be good. Got a slip screen, of course. This guy's the king of screens right now. We'll let him score. I wanted him to score there. The slip screen, man. I hate the slip screen so much, man. Like, when I call it, I don't get any yards. But when someone else calls it, it's a TD on me every time. I don't know. All hail the slip screen, I guess. I don't know. We're going onside kick. I mean, we're up 21-6. Might as well try to get the ball back. It's so stupid. This guy's so stupid. I mean, he's got the game. He's got the game, and he's just going to hand it to me. Like, that was the dumbest thing that I think I've ever seen. What you just saw right there. 21-6, and you just onside kick for no reason. In this game, you can't even get the onside kick. Once again, he's going to press. You see how he pressed right there? Immediate. It's systematic. It's very simple, guys. Once you sit down, once you play a little bit, once you focus, there's nothing he's going to be able to do. Because look, he's got one safety up top. Safety ain't going to be a deep. There's two men under. I can beat that with the in route. You see what I'm saying? So it's there he dropped off. But I still have the blocks in case he blitz. He was offsides. I probably should have chucked it up just in case, you know, because he doesn't have safety over top. Sherman in my stupid game. I hate game flow. I don't understand why we have to do this game flow and crap like that. But just play the game. But I don't know. It's what they want to do. So it's their game. I bought their game. They didn't buy mine. So it's all right. But it is frustrating. And it's okay to be frustrated. Okay, it's not okay to be a jerk about it. I don't know why I can't catch the ball, but I literally can't catch it. So we're gonna have to go away from it. He's something about the base play, but that's why you have 5-6 of the plays you can go to. In a sense, if he shuts down a base play, and you see right now, I mean, he's doing a good job of shutting down a base play. Here, what I'm gonna do, because I'm getting blitz like every play. I think if I spread him out here, I could maybe be able to hit this quick base. So I think I could seal the edge. Get a block in there. There's Moreno on the carry. All right, so right here from the 18-yard line, this is something that I've been doing lately. I go to this ATL deep in play. I throw two fades up. I got the in route over there. I still got that route to Moreno that I really like. And then you see, I mean, there's pressure blitz again. I mean, it's literally man blitz every single play with this guy. So if I could set audibles, this wouldn't be a problem, unfortunately, because I'm trying to show an example of something. I can't do that. And that should have been a touchdown. Unfortunately, we're on the 14-yard line. I shouldn't have called that play there. Whew! Okay. So since the blitz beater, actually, let's see how it fares. Well, we got the press. We'll go pay. We'll go PA post. That's so frustrating. Wow. Do you take your three here? Yeah, you take your three. Here's why you take your three here. If you score a touchdown, it's going to be about 2 minutes. Obviously, you take your... Okay, so first of all, fourth and five or more, I say take your three every time. That's just my personality. But more specifically and more systematically thought out here, since it's 3 minutes, there's a little over 3 minutes left in the half, that's plenty of time for me to get a stop and score. But if there was only like 2 minutes or like a minute and a half, if I would have wasted that time to score, and then he would have got the ball back, if it would have only been like a minute or so, in that situation, I wouldn't have enough time to get a stop and score. I may have enough time to get a stop or a pick six, but that doesn't a pick six doesn't happen every drive. So I have to think that all that out. That's why I take three there. But and there's obviously other situations where I don't take three. So all right, I really hope that he runs another screen, because I'm right there. That's so frustrating. I went over. Okay, so you guys noticed that I was clicked on the D end. I went over there to put him in a contain to stop the screen. I got caught on the D end. Since the D end was blitzing, the computer forced me to blitz instead of running the screen. It's another thing I think that they need to fix. I think that you should be able to go wherever you want with your user, as opposed to having to go to whatever is assigned to your user. But, you know, I think every, you know, I don't know exactly how that would work, but I think that it needs to happen. But that's just me. So we're throwing the contain there, finally. We actually finally can use the contain. I don't know what happened. He ran slip screen like 5 times out of this. Corner routes and sack, lunch, sandwich. Russell, that's a fumble. It's a fumble. You just fumble. I mean, this guy. So one of the things that I want to do now in this situation is I want to send pressure off the right edge and drop a contain over there on that edge. I've got this middle of the field. And I was right there on it. Dang it. All over that. So I got him in 3rd and 4. What was stupid right there that I did was I blitzed in a second and long. Rule of thumb, you don't blitz in second and long. Because think about it, especially if it's second and like 19, if you drop into coverage D, typically they're only going to get about 5-6 yards, set you up for an opportunity to blitz on 3rd and 4. Now, in this situation, it's a lot harder to blitz than it was in the other situation. So here I'm going to come up, I'm going to try to get aggressive here, and I just like effed up there. Luckily, Cliff Harris came off. Okay, in this situation, I need to drop here. We need to drop here, and we need to hope that we got him here. I need this left seam. Fumble. Ah, it's all over that. Dang it. It's all right. That stop would have been huge, though. I mean, a stop right there would have been huge, because then I get the ball. I would have probably scored a touchdown, and I mean, that just would have been really huge right there. If I would have been able to get that stop. I'm really worried about the screen. There it is. Dang it. Good read. Good read. I got to give him his props on that one. I got to give him his props. Okay, so now we're going to get into the cover 3 blitz with the contain over on that side. I'm going to drop the middle with Huff. I need to get down here and press this crap. Oh! Did you see that? That was terrible. Oh my gosh. I can't believe that just happened. Get off me. Thank you! Use a pick. Go, Huff. Oh, crap. That was stupid of me. Okay, so the play before that, I was holding ball hawk to pick, and it literally threw me off the ball. Okay, now see what you see. Okay, real quick. We're going to go real quick here, so I want to try to explain it. But basically, we're going to set him up for over the top to Demarius. And you see he did it, so. Okay, so that's another example of what happens when you get over-aggressive. And I go out of bounds there. I know I can't stop the clock with timeouts because I've wasted them all. So I go to bounce there so I can, and I'm still in room. I still have room to dot him up if he does this again. Okay? But I hope you've seen the adjustment. I didn't even mean to go. I meant to go to the empty 5 while I didn't do it. Unfortunately, I accidentally, but I wanted to go so quick here. And I'm going to do the same thing again. Because if he's going to keep doing it, I'm not in the mood for him to keep doing it. See, here he's probably going to drop out into 2-man. And you see he does. But I have the in route to beat that, and what's good about that, it's actually going to get me in a pretty good situation here to make a field goal. Now I run the bunch Z spot to get me down the field the rest of the way. Here he's going to go. He's still in 2-man, I believe. So I should have an opportunity to user catch this route. Finally, we make a user catch. Here we pause, and we take our field goal. Just got it off. Matt Prater missed it. Dang it. That is so incredibly frustrating. That just took the wind out of me, because that field goal. It's not that big of a deal, but we got plenty of time to catch up, but we go in 12-21 down 9. A lot better than going in 9-21 down 13, but still down 2 scores. So to me, that's not a huge deal. But that would have been a huge momentum boost. I mean, I get a pick, and I think I found the defense for this guy. It's the edge pressure out of the cover 3. Drop the contain over here for the screen. Here you see, last time he went to that lead option. And I got caught up on stupid lineman again. Luckily, Terrence Knighton's a boss. Okay, let's see what he's got here. I need a drop. Oh! There's my guy! That's my guy! Talked about him in the depth chart, man. Boykit or whatever his name is. Boyett. Jason Boyett or whatever his name is, man. The dude just makes plays. He's everywhere, man. 85 pursuit, I believe, is what he's got. So, this situation, it's that cover 3. It's that cover 3. Because he can't, there's nothing else that he's done so far. He hasn't done well against the cover 3 when I've called it. So, I feel like I have a shot here. Probably going to go to that screen. Oh, that's a heartbreaker. Good route. And he's going to run up. Percy Harvin's such a... tough. This guy's not bad. He's not... I don't want to say that. But, he's all right. But, it's a good game, I think. Now that I'm finally getting all my clicks here in. Got my play. There's a draw. I got 3 guys coming up the middle. How do you stop a draw, man? I don't know. Never knew draws were any good. Here I'm going to make a quick RB sub. I'm going to put Ayers in for Malik Jackson because he's passing so much. I think Ayers is going to do a little bit better of a job than Johnson or Jackson is, just for the passing. If it was a running game, if he was running the ball more, I would have definitely put in Jackson. Okay, so that's just a quick adjustment for you. And, of course, now he comes out and... too wide. Toss. 3rd and inches. Excuse me. 3rd and inches, huh? Alright, so right here, we're just going to run the... I really feel confident in this cover 3. It may not stop him. But I think that it'll be mighty fine here. Oh, yes, sir! That was a really good play by Von Miller, Trevathan, who dropped over there. Really good play by him there. Let's see. He should go for a field goal because that puts him up. Well, no, he should go for this. He's right. He's right on this. So here I'm going to go silver shoe pinch, run the man blitz. I'm going to get right over Harvin, and I'm pressing the crap out of this son. If he runs a screen, he may have me here. He flips the play. I think that's a tell that he actually is running a screen. Well, I have to just play my assignment. I think I just got offsides. Dang it. I just went offsides. That was a stop. I wasn't offsides. Oh, it's bullcrap. There's no way I was offsides there. Wow. Dang it. Alright. Well, we're going to go silver shoot pinch again. I don't think he liked that look. I want him to throw the ball to Lockett. Toss. Oh, I should have seen that coming. He went to that last time in a single back ace. Dang it. Alright, we're gonna play this game here. Let's see what we've got. I need to watch the... Oh, no. Harris. Caged. Good play by Cliff Harris. He had me over top. I mean, he had me beat, but luckily he threw to the outside as opposed to the middle. Because I got sucked down. I thought he was running zone weak. Alright, I'm going to go silver shoot again. Alright, so this is the formation. He wants to run screen or that PA play. There's the PA play. We're all over that! What? Wow. I don't know what to do. So now we're going to have to pick the pace up offensively. I mean, that just is what it is. Oh, Trent Holiday? Try to block some kicks? Alright, so 28-9. Man, tough. Two slip screens, and then two bullets right at my guy. It's always nice. I just feel like this guy is just pathetic. It's whatever. There's Trenton Holiday. There's Trenton Holiday for you, ladies. Oh! Trendon. Should have back-juked. That's what everybody says. Only problem is if you back-juke on a kick return, you get you lose all your turbo. Same thing here. I mean, we're just going to do this until he decides to get out of it. If he keeps running the man blitz, I mean, this is... So there you see, he gets out of it, but this is our man beater. We'll reset back to bunch. He's going to bump. Well, Eric Decker, son. Eric Decker doesn't want to catch the football today. He just wants to throw it off his hands. Tough. All right, so that's obvious two men under. I mean, see how they came out? That's obvious two men under. I mean, it's just no question. So there you see the... Actually, I think he dropped a cover two, but this play beats cover two. Play beats everything if you run it right. And right now, we're trying to get it down to 9-13. Or 9 to... Wait a minute. And you see, if he's just going to sit in that cover two, I'm going to throw that all day. You can't sit in the cover two. The way I motion him, you can't sit in the cover two. Just fact. It's just fact. You can't. Because he's unbumpable on that. It's a hitch route. And you, the way you motion him is very important as well. See how I get him out there like that? See, that time he got bumped. That was unfortunate. I think I snapped it a little too quick. But if you snap it just right, he won't get bumped. Obviously, you have to read that. And that was me getting a little excited that I was getting something going offensively. But, so you see that right there? You see the safety go single high, and then you see him go press like that? Immediate tell. It's cover zero. Immediate tell. Because it's what he's done all game. And there's no reason for me to try to run the other plays when this is what's going to do it. Here he's offsides again. I'm just going to lob up and take a touchdown. It's just stupid. Guy makes no adjustments. It's whatever. We'll take six. You know? It's what it is. I guarantee he runs the man blitz again on the goal line, and we're going to dot him up out of that tight doubles. Remember the way we like to do it, though. We like to come out in the close play because that's going to give us the best chance to get that audible glitz, audible play. So you see, now we're down two scores. I mean, two scores is nothing, especially with the way of my defense. I feel like my defense can always lock up, but that's just my personal opinion. There you see Eric Decker going up and getting it, and he drops the ball. Yeah, I don't know. All I can do is deliver the ball in his hands. I mean, he wants to drop it. It's what it is. Guy did absolutely nothing to make him drop it. Wide open route. Practice it and practice it a billion times. Works every time. I don't understand it. It's what it is. We are fighting through some adversity. Here we're down. 13 points. We would have been down 11. I would have much rather been down 11 because that would have given us the opportunity to take the lead. Or not take the lead, but tie it up with a field goal and a couple of other things, you know, good swinging our way. There's your slip screen. We got your slip screen, buddy. No more slip screen. See, you may ask, why am I running cover three the cover three blitz every single time? Because that's what he's doing. Because I have to adjust based off what he's doing. If I run the team in under coverage D, or if I run the silver shoot pinch every play, he's got me beat with that. Because of the way he's running the same play every time, or the same basic play every time. He's running slip screen, and then he's running, you know, whatever else off that. But because they're the same things every time, I got to get over there on that corner. But because they're the same things every single time, the same basic thing, you have the that route right there, and then you have the slip screen, and then you have the PA play. So it's crossing routes and slip screen. The cover three does a good job against that. Silver shoot pinch would do a good job against, like, if they were running outs or something like that, because you could press up and man up on that. But you see, it goes back to this, guys. I have to adjust to what my opponent's doing. Right now, the way my opponent is playing, I'm in trouble right here. I'm in trouble. I'm in big, big trouble. Luckily, I got out of that. I need to press this guy. I'm going to press him every rip. And that should have... I don't know. I thought that should have been mine right there. That's all right. So, got him in a 4-3. I mean, I've gotten him in fourth down a couple times. I just keep missing that one little... get the stuff. Last time... last time I went silver shoot pinch, I'm going to hold off silver shoot pinch right now, because I really do think he's just going to run a slip screen. Get over there. I knew that was coming. He never throws the post route. Most people throw the post route. I guess that's why I'm going over there. Well, I guess it's also because he's rolling out to the right. You know, this strong corner roll wouldn't be too bad. Alright, so there's official trips. We had the crossing patterns here. Load option. I didn't like that look. I did not like that look. We're going to make a little adjustment on that. I need to watch screen. Dang it! Gosh. Wow. Sorry about that, guys. I've yelled a couple times. Oh, my gosh. That's tough. That's tough. Lurked him right. I baited him right to the guy. I was all over that. So now I've got a new idea in my head. So because he's running split offset so much. One of the things I think that I could do to get a little bit more pressure to make him have to throw it a little faster. Silver shoot pinch. I use the running back. If the running back goes on a screen, I take a screen. If the running back doesn't go on a screen, I take the crossing route over the middle. And we'll take that draw. If he gets three, it'll be 31-15. I'm still down 16. I can still get back. I just have to convert on my two-point conversions. Unfortunately, I've dropped the ball twice, and they've been wide open both times. But that's the story of this game. Okay, I need to shade. This is the look for the screen. Now he audibled out. I need to get off. I need to get back on sides here. I'm going to press this route here. Pick! Raheem Moore, big time. Big time pick there. So that drive was kind of hurting because I felt like I was all over him every single time. And for whatever reason, I mean, he literally just frustrated me because I felt like I was there a couple times. And Raheem Moore made a really good play. Obviously, that's a route that doesn't beat man, and he tried to make it beat man. There you see that right there, that tell. That odd, it's easy. It's easy mode right now. Because all I have to do is just audible. Now, if he doesn't audible with me, I know it's there. And because he doesn't change the safeties, I know that he hasn't audibled with me. You see, there's that beat press animation, and there's a lob. It's clockwork for right now. Because I don't want to overcomp. We have literally yet to go to the zone beater in the running attack. He just hasn't given it to me. Okay? Now, you see here, 7-point ball game, you always go for two in this situation. Because if I get the 2 points, he goes to 23-28. And then if he scores a field goal, I'm now in position to... And I called the wrong play. Dang it. Totally called the wrong play. Dang it. All right. Well, we're going to have to run it to the other side. Actually, no, we're not. We're going to flip the play. Sorry about that. Okay, so we're going to motion Welker out. There's Welker. See, Welker, I guess, actually catches the ball. I don't know if we looked at the stats, though. Welker has a lower spec catch and a lower catch in traffic than Decker. And I think he actually has a lower catching as well. It may just have to deal with the size of the guy. I haven't really quite figured that out yet. But, because, I use Steve Largent, my Ultimate Team. He has 99 catch in traffic and 94 spectacular catch. So, now we're back in the game. If you're still watching, you guys are probably a little bit upset with my yelling, but we're back in the game. So now I really like that cover 3, because that cover 3 boxed him for the most part. The only thing it didn't get was this route to Harvin, which I can lurk. There we go. There's the pressure. And you see the pressure off the right edge, untouched. I guess play action, it typically will come from the defensive end. If they don't go play action, then it will come through the B gap or the A gap sometimes if you're lucky, but that's the cover 3 pressure. We talked about the right edge pressure. But we haven't been going with the zone blitz yet because it just hasn't been a good situation, because the way he's running everything is literally to the other side. Here I'm going to bring Boykit over, and I'm just taking the corner right away. I'm just saying you can't throw a corner out because it's what he's been doing. You see, I mean, this guy's been so one-dimensional offensively and even defensively, especially defensively, because if you see, you know it's two-man, you know it's cover one. It's a safety rotation up top. When he goes single high, he's running press blitz. If he doesn't go single high, he's running cover two or cover two-man. It's clockwork. And so you just – all we're doing here – oh, shoot. Oh, no. I gotta watch out. Corner outs, and that's a big sack. That was a big sack. We sent Silvershoot pinch there. Unfortunately, he came out in snugs, which was a pretty good checkmate by him, because he knew it was he probably thought it might be a man blitz or something. I started hot routing everybody to the outside, like corner out, deep blues, stuff like that. So I had two deep blues and two curl flats, and then I had the user. And luckily, I mean, it just worked out for me. Oh, I can't. I gotta ask Tweezy for some help on punt returning, because I can't ever do it. But 23-28, here we're in primetime situation. Primetime position, we go down, we score, we get a stop, we go out victorious. But in this situation, you want to score quick, because you want to give your defense opportunity to stop, or you want to score really late. You can't have an in-between drive. So here you see there's that two-man look, so we're going to go two-man beater. Finally, we get the bunch route working. Haven't done too well passing. I've thrown 11 incomplete passes. So that was a good checkmate by him. That's finally something I can deal with him. What was a good move there? So he backed everybody off after calling two-man, so he didn't get the jam. And it just threw my read off a little bit. I mean, I don't know if it would have stopped anything I was doing, but it did throw my read off, that's for sure. Here's two-man again, third and two. And we'll take that all day, Welker. See, I think what I was doing earlier with the route was I was throwing it a little bit too. And see, now with 2 minutes, with us being 2 minutes, ball at the 30, I'm going to actually take a shot here at the fade route if he gives me time in the pocket. So there was a bad throw. Because if you notice, what happened was two things happened there. First of all, I didn't take it all the way down to 2 minute warning like I thought I was going to. Second of all, I threw it way too early, so I didn't get the fade animation. And third of all, I threw it into double coverage and tried to click on a user that, which you can't do that in this year's game. So all that whole play there was bad by me, and I was fortunate I didn't get picked. But we'll go back to Welker. I love how he's dropped it, you know, a couple times. Now we're in a bad situation. We're 3rd-10. I would feel confident here taking 3 because of how well my defense has been playing second half. But hopefully it won't come down to that. Demaryius Thomas says, "No, sir." Boom, baby. Right there, I knew that Wes Welker Jr. wasn't going to be able to get to the point that I wanted it to get to. So I simply checked. Saw he was not usering the middle. Wide open on the Z spot. Clicked on, make the user play. And that might have just won me the game. Okay, first attempt from 11. This is the first time you're going to see the three-headed rushing attack today. We're going to run the inside zone. And, I mean, it's... That may be why you haven't seen... I don't know what happened there. My guard just kind of ran away from the guy. But right now we're clocking. Basically is what we're doing. We're basically clocking. I mean, it's obviously not something that you like, but sometimes you need to do it. In this situation, there's no reason for me to score right now. Okay, you see how he's backing off, he's pressed, he's trying to change up. But I know. I know it's 2-man under. So what I'm going to do, actually, is take him to the single back. Doubles here. You see I have 5-on-5 blocking. So we should win this matchup, especially because there's quarters personnel. So I feel pretty confident taking this. Obviously, last time he came right through, but this time we get the block. And we get about 5 yards back. We're in a 3rd-and-7 situation. Much better situation offensively than a 3rd-and-12 if we throw an incomplete pass. And you see, so that's something that's very simple that you can do. So now in this situation, you see he comes out 2-man under again. Now I'm going to the man beater. He's going to audible out. Call T.O. I think he kind of finally figured out that we're clocking. So now what we're going to do, we're just going to run the Z-spot play real quick. Try to catch him off guard. Huge play by Wes Welker. You can't not score there. You can't not score there. Because, and see, now you definitely go for 2. Because you've taken the lead. But you want to go for 2 because you want to make it a 3-score game. So that he has to at least, you know, I mean, at worst, which for me, in my opinion, I don't even think my defense is going to give that up. But if we give him a scoring position, we can bank on trying to hold him to 3. All right. Motion out. Decker finally makes a play. Boom! Huge 2-point conversion right there by me. And you see, I mean, we started out, we weren't doing so hot on the 2-point conversions. We started out, we dropped 2 in consecutive, came back, stayed consistent with our scheme. We knew that our scheme would work. I mean, we made adjustments. You've yet to see the zone beater the entire video. He hasn't ran zone the entire game. What do you want? You know what I mean? I hope that makes sense. You know, if they're going to continue to stay in the same defense, continue beating them the same way. There's no reason for me to go run a play that beats zone and try to make it beat man. There's just no reason for that. Okay, so here, drop that over there. I didn't get the blitz set up. Oh, he got me in the seam. Chris Harris almost made a great play, though. So they got me clicking. Now in this situation, I'm still in the back of my mind, I'm thinking he's going to run a screen. Okay, so that's why I'm not running the zone blitz. I am running the zone blitz, but I'm running it from the cover 3 run defense version as opposed to the... Because that's what he's doing. You see what I'm saying? Hopefully you guys see what I'm saying. So here, man up. I know my responsibility is deep. See, I knew I had to stay with the streak, so I'm willing to give up that little underneath crap. Here I'm going to go to coverage D, shade everybody out, play a little off coverage here, Oh, I thought we were getting... Oh, we did get that, my boy! Oh, my gosh. Your boy, Jay Boyd. Wow, that was awesome. Oh, my gosh. What a way to end this crazy game. Wow. Went to the 3-3-5 two-man under coverage defense after sending that cover three blitz the entire game for the most part. And we come out victorious with the one guy that nobody knows on the Denver Broncos. What up? Huge play by Boyk. Huge play. I mean, there you see the power of that hitch, right? I mean, typically I can throw it in the beginning of the game, too. I don't know what I was probably just a little off on my users. But this thing is pretty good. Especially for guys that like to continuously run cover three. And because he's going to run man again and again and again and again and again, I'm about to dot him for 30 over the top for a six here. I'm calling my shot. Right here, I'm calling my shot. If he runs the same play he just came out in, I'm throwing the ball for a touchdown. Fact. Because the way he's doing it, he can't beat me. Can't beat me. Because look, he's pressing up. Yep, he's doing the same thing. So we're going on it. 6 points right here. 6 points. We lied. We lied. We had him over the top. We just didn't throw the ball. But real quick, guys, I want to show you this highlight. This is the potential with this play here as we close out. Thank you guys so much for watching, guys. It meant the world to me that you guys stuck with me all the way through it, even the times when I was really upset. But, man, take a look at Wes Welker getting big right here. Watch this. Ow. Show off for the ladies, though. Ow. 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 That's awesome. And then, like, the one that Decker dropped. I feel like that's even a cool animation as well. These two-point conversion plays are really effective, guys. These little hitch routes. Watch this. Ow. And I just come down with it, though. Look at that. They tackled each other. Watch this. I don't think they hit Decker. They literally tackled each other. And Decker's laying on top saying, "We should have been the champions, my friends." Thanks for watching, guys. Catch us next week on the Offensive Scheme of the Week, Defensive Scheme of the Week. We put out consistent videos like this. Like I said, if you find a scheme, stick with it. In times of struggle and in times of triumph, you typically will come out victorious in a game of Madden. Thanks for watching.